Hi everybody, hope you are all fine. This is Atik. Welcome to our YouTube channel Engineering Drive. Let us discuss about what is an interface in Java and how we can write a Java program by making use of this concept. In my previous class of Java, already I have discussed with all of you what is an abstract class and how we can use an abstract class with an example program. Dear students, this interface is also similar to that of an abstract class, but there are some changes, there are some differences that we need to observe. Okay, first of all, speaking to the theoretical point of view, an interface is a pure abstract class. What is an interface? An interface is a pure abstract class. So already those who are having idea of what is an abstract class, you will get clear picture now. In abstract class, we may have abstract methods as well as concrete methods. Means methods with body or methods without body. Both types of methods are possible in abstract class. But in interface, there will be only abstract methods, which means the methods which does not have body, we call those methods as abstract methods. So in an interface is a pure abstract class, which means point number two, an interface contains only abstract methods, only abstract methods. So this is the example. I have taken one example program also. I will explain you that how an interface can be used in a Java program. So this is point number two in interface. And point number three, and why the concept of interface is used in Java programming. Sometimes we want to create a class that will give only instructions. Which instructions? What to do? That's all. But not how to do it. Then in those circumstances, interface will be used. So for example, let me tell you, this is an interface. An interface in Java can be used with the help of a keyword interface. And what is the name of the interface? I have taken marks. Now opening brace, closing brace. So this is the way of writing an interface. Now you can see here in this interface, how many methods are there? Two methods, void internal, void external. Whether these methods are abstract methods or concrete methods. Abstract methods means methods which does not have body. Concrete methods means methods which have body. So they are not concrete methods. They are abstract methods. So we can say it is an interface because an interface contains only abstract methods. Sir, can we define normal methods also, sir, interface with body? No, it is not possible. Okay, unlike abstract class, in interface, we can't define normal methods. Only we need to define abstract methods now. So what is the use of this abstract methods? No use. Is it right? So the class which is going to implement this interface. Now I have taken one class. What is the name of the class? Detail implements marks, which means this class detail want to implement this marks interface. You know what is the meaning of implementing here? Implementing means it should provide, this class detail should provide definition to this abstract methods. So you got clarity now? Interface will give the instructions only what to do, but the class that is going to implement the interface needs to know how to do it. Is it clear? So this is point number three. An interface only says what to do, but not how to do it. Whose responsibility is to know how to do it? The class that is implementing the interface. So dear students, this is very, very important part. If we have only an interface in our Java program, there is no use. After interface, compulsory there should be some class that is going to implement that interface. Now in this example, let us take one example program and let me show you the working of this interface concept. Class detail implements marks. So this class should implement this interface marks. So how many methods are there in this interface? Two methods. These two methods are abstract methods. So how I need to provide definition to this method? So compulsory, we need to make use of the access modifier public and then write the name of the method. Void internal. Now this is nothing but method definition. So here what I am writing, I want to display the internal marks. System dot out dot print ln here internal is equal to, let us say for a particular student maximum marks for internal is 30. So internal is equal to 30 marks. Similarly, there is one more method, external, which is also an abstract method. So we need to, the class detail should implement this method. So how it can implement? Same public void external system dot out dot print ln here external is equal to, for example, 70 marks. Now implementation part has been completed now. So the class detail implements marks, means in marks we are having two abstract methods. These two abstract methods definitions has been given. Who has given this definition? Class detail has given these definitions. Now sir, whether public modifier is compulsory, sir? Yes, this is also a very, very important point. The class that is implementing the interface should give or should provide the definitions to all the abstract methods of the interface. So how many abstract methods are there? Two abstract methods. For all these two abstract methods, we have provided the definition. If this class does not provide the definition, you will get error. And one more important point is, compulsory, the method which is provided definition should have the modifier public. Okay, compulsory should have the modifier public. Is it clear? Next thing. Now, I want to create an object for this class now. Sir, can we create object for the interface, sir? No, it is not possible. As we know that we can't create object for abstract class. Similarly, interface is also one abstract class only. It is a pure abstract class. That's why for interface also we can't create object. In order to create object, we need to create an object for the class which implements this interface marks. So that's why what I am doing here, detail D is equal to new, that detail. So I have created an object of class detail D. Now by using this object, can I invoke these methods? Yes. So D dot internal. Next D dot external. So D dot internal means control will directly come to this method. D dot external means control will directly come to this method. And how many lines you will get output? The expected output of this program will be internal is equal to 30 marks. External is equal to 70 marks. So dear students, this is how the concept of interface works. Okay, now in my next class, I will be discussing about what about the variables in interface. Can we initialize the variables in interface, whether their behavior is similar to that of normal class variables? Okay, each and everything I will be specifying in my next set of videos. So today we have discussed about what is an interface, how it is different from an abstract class, and I have told one example program also. So with this, let me close my today's session of video. See you soon, everybody. Take care. Allah Hafiz.